Good morning. My name's Matt. Welcome to my studio and my wife's studio. That's her part. She's painting a lion or something. So we're painting Supercar. This week we've had some problems. First of all, it's a Saturday morning. I got a coffee. It's been a rough week and I lost pretty much about 20 minutes of footage because I record on my phone and it maxed out, and when I uploaded to iCloud and then took off my phone, took those videos off my phone, it also took off iCloud. So I need a new phone. So trying to work that out. There is footage. We get to that bit. And then there's missing footage. And then I'll do a reveal of what we got. I say it's been a rough week. There's tree pollen. Tree blossom out. And I'm allergic to tree pollen. And my eyes are stinging. No matter how much antihistamine I have. Good news is, we have reached this little studio has reached like 1400 subscribers, which is brilliant. Appreciated. You've asked, I've got a lot of good feedback. So let's get on with Supergirl and show you where I'm at with her and what I've done and what you've missed. Apologies. I'm working on it. Thanks, guys. Okay, so I'm doing the eyes at the moment. Apologies that it went quiet for a second there. I guess I was concentrating. So I've done pupils. Well, the shape of the eyes. And with a 000 Winsor & Newton Cera 7 brush. Just want to get this blue. There's the blue I'm using is ultramarine blue. Be easier if I turned her up the other way. And just go inside the black, which was grey, dark, very dark grey. It was dark grey. I seldom use black these days because it deadens colour. Bit of blue, leave that to dry for a little bit. So we need to go lighter, which we got some sunrise blue. And I'm just gonna add a little bit of that to the original colour. just the outside of what we painted. And lower a bit. There we go. Leave that to dry. Back to sunrise yellow. Just a little bit on the brush. And we're going to go on the inner part of the eye. Do is we could put a glaze over the top just to blend it together. Like that. Back to our dark grey and put in our pupils. Just build up until you got the right size you require. A little push with that one. This one. A little push. I believe that's dry. For a minute or so. Keep checking. Keep checking because of the size of the eye. Is it iris? I'm not sure. And tidy up that area there, and around there, it says, bottom of that iris isn't how I want it. That better? If we go back to on white. We can put catch light in, which could eyes are done. Wait till that's dry and then we're going to varnish. This is gold yellow. It's a bit on the orangey side. So I just want to get into the S part. Nice yellow. I'm going to leave that to dry and come back to her later. But she's looking great today. Nice. The eyes look dry. So I've got a bit of time to put some varnish on. This is probably the most boring application of any paint process, because it's gloss, and boring for you too, because it's just gloss varnish by Vallejo. My coffee's gone cold. Ugh. Right. Those in because I don't need to do any more work to those. And gloss those lips. Beautiful. Right, I'm gonna go work. I'll see you for the next part. Right, now we have some work to do. We've got some charred brown by Vallejo Gegen Color. And just gonna tidy up and finish the eyes, eyelashes, eyebrows. So I just wanna go. If the paint will let me. few highlights to delete the yellow, which we're going to use. Intenso. Deep yellow. Thin it down a little bit. Just in some areas. I'm going to start off with using some red for the S, and we're going to use Scarlet Red, which we've used before. Bit of water to make it run a bit better. And I just want to run this down. Just down the inside of this. Carefully. Using our Winsor & Newton 000. It's a very good brush. Get a bigger brush. We can use Winsor & Newton miniature number 3. That'll do. So red in the S is done. Might need another coat a bit later with unhighlighted. She looks like that. And now for the red on the skirt, same colour. The base colour for the skirt is done in
Scarlet, red, like game color. I was deciding what color blue to do first as a base. These are night blue, but I've got a magic blue, which is perfect for superheroes or top. So I'm gonna do a base color in magic blue. If I want to lighten it, I can. If I want to add shadows, then I'll use the night blue as a wash a bit later on. So the next few minutes you're going to see me putting on a bit of paint. I got to change a brush. A little area in there I can't get to. Let's change it. What have we got? Well, I've just got, look at that, you see that? That one's ready for the bin. This neckline. Hold their breath. Looks nice. I'm gonna finish this bit. Get back to you. This color is Scalophus Scrofulous Brown. And use it as a base color for our yellow. Yellow. I hate you in yellow. But it requires it. And my water's gone blue, so I'm gonna go disappear. Right, so where was I? Bit of water with the Scrofulous Brown. And this may take a few layers. That was a good choice. I could have gone proper orange for a base. Okay, this brush I'm using is Artis Opus number 3. It's kind of long. It's pointy. It's very good for getting into areas. I'm not worried about getting onto the red. I can take it off. Okay, I'm going to show you how to take it off. So we're going to take a clean brush, a bit of water on the end, and we're just going to remove that. and then we can come back in a little bit later with a fine brush.
Like that. It's dirty. I think we need to talk about this in a certain way. I do most of my recording on my phone, and it's got very poor storage. So there was me yesterday filming and talking, and storage ran out. So an upgrade to my phone would be very beneficial at the moment. So, I've done her top. I've gone with the magic blue. You've seen that bit. And then we've done mid-tone with magic blue and night blue. And then a little bit of wash in the dark, deepest areas. Like that. And then gone over the top again with a little bit of magic blue just to lighten it. That's that. She's all, the top's been varnished, and that's okay now. I just gotta work on the skirt, which is this bit, and hopefully my storage won't run out. So the Scrofulous Brown is a base coat. I need to do the trim across the bottom, which will be the same, so I'm going to do that.